Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen. Sayyidi wa habibi wa nuri qalbi wa thamarat fuadi. Tabbil kulubi wa dawaiha wa aafiyatil abdani wa shifaiha. Wa nuril absari wa ziyaiha abil qasim Muhammad. That we normally hear about the Shahada of Zahraa salamullahi alayha is that there are some people who make argument that the way the narration stated about the Shahada and the martyrdom of Zahraa is not true. And they have their reasoning. And tonight, I want you and I to take a journey from the Quranic point of view to see whether those claims are true or not. The first suspicion they say Fatima Zahraa salamullah alayha was not killed by their nails. That the narrator said, after her house was attacked, and this story that I mentioned to you, check in Al-Bidayah wa Al-Nihaya, written by Ibn al-Athir and Tabari, in his Tariq al-Tabari, is quoted this. What happened? Their argument is this, and I want us to listen careful, especially tonight. They said there was no nails at the time of Rasulullah. Nails are something came later after the hayat of Rasulullah. For that matter, when you say Fatima Zahra was killed by the nail, that is false. Because nails never existed at the time of the Prophet. Allahu Akbar. Then I just want you and I to ask Quran, Ya Quran, was there a nail at the time of Rasul or not? That's one of the arguments. Argument number two, they said, at the time of the Prophet, there was no doors. It was just curtains. They used to put no doors, nothing. It's just curtains. There was no door. How would we say that the Fatima salamullah alayha was squeezed and killed between the wall and the door? This is exaggeration. It never happened because there was no door at the time of the Prophet. I want you to listen from the Quranic point of view. And I'm going to give you the reference from the Quran, what Quran says. The answer number one, for those who say there was no nails at the time of the Rasulullah, Allah, Quran said that is false. Allah said at the time of Nuh, there was nails. Nuh alayhi salam, during his time. And this is not the hadith, it's the Quran is stating. In which surah? Surah Al-Qamar. Read Surah Al-Qamar properly and then pay attention to what the words of Allah in this surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Kadhabat qawma Nuh. The Nuh, his people, denied him. They called him a liar. Then what happened? فَدَعَى رَبَّهُ. He called Allah. What did he say? أَنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ فَانْتَصَرُ. Ya Allah, I've been defeated. Ya Allah, I ask for your victory. Now listen to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَحَمَلْنَاهُ. We carry Nuh alayhi salam. What did we carry him on? Ala dhati alwa wa dusur. Alwa means woods. Dusur, nails. This was the Quran. Now dusur, look at tafsir. Allah said, we carry Nuh alayhi salam on two things. One is what? The woods, alwa, the boards, wa dusur, and the nails. These are the only things that carry Nuh alayhi salam. If Nuh alayhi salam, at his time, there was nails, and you are now lying to yourself, or lying to myself, that there was not nails at the time of the Prophet. That is from the Quran. Now put that aside. Number two, those who say there was no doors at the time of the Prophet, it's all just curtains. Also read Surah An-Nur, Ayah 61. Surah An-Nur, Ayah 61. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَيْسَ عَلَى الْأَعْمَى حَرَجْ وَلَا عَلَى الْمَرِيضِ حَرَجْ. And then he continued, لَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْكُمْ أَن تَأْكُلُوا فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no harm to eat in your houses. أَوْ بُيُوتِ أَعْمَامِكُمْ أَوْ بُيُوتِ أَخَالَاتِكُمْ. Allah continued, and then he said, أَوْ مَا مَلَكْتُمْ مَفَاتِحَهُ. Allah says, or the houses that you own the keys. Now question, curtains need a key? I haven't seen it. Alhamdulillah. Despite the progress that we have today, there haven't been a curtain that we have seen with the what? With the keys. Quran says, أَوْ مَا مَلَكْتُمْ مَفَاتِحَ. The houses you own the keys. And the Quran was revealed at the time of the Prophet, right? It's not after the Prophet. You say that this ayah was after the Prophet. No, at the time of the Prophet, the Quran says, Malaktum Mafata. You own the keys, meaning the houses has doors and the keys. You lock them and unlock them. That is number two. Number three, for those who say there's no door at the time of the Prophet, you go to the history from the historian point of view. What did they say? When the Prophet went to Medina, the first thing he did was to build a masjid, right? After he built the masjid, all the masjid that the Prophet built was doors to the houses of some of the companions. They come from their house to the masjid. Then the order came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rasulullah, you have to close all the doors, except two doors, you have to leave. All doors have to be closed. Except two, no more than that. The first door you have to leave, Ya Rasulullah, is your own door. Number two is the door of Amir al-Mu'mineen, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
The Prophet came and closed all the doors except the two doors Allah told him not to. Now, do we have any excuse to say there was no door at the time of the Prophet? That's number three. Number four, we all read in the history, what is called Bab Khaybar. Listen careful. Bab, not Sitr Khaybar. It's a Bab Khaybar. And it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari also. Bab Khaybar. How did it happen? When Rasulullah sent the first Khalifa, the second Khalifa, they were not able to conquer. Then the Prophet says, لَأُعْطِيَنَّ رَايَةَ غَدًا لِرَجُلٍ يُحَبُّهُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَيُحَبُّ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. And this Bab Khaybar, read in the history, they say it was so strong that you need 40 strong men to open and close. And are we talking this at the time of the Prophet or after the Prophet? At the time of the Prophet. The Bab Khaybar was there. That people used to open and close at that time. Where do we come from this? Where do we get this from? That at the time of the Prophet, there was no door, there was nothing. It was just curtains. Allahu Akbar. Bab Khaybar is also another proof that Rasulullah time, there was door and there was nails. This is one of the suspicious. But now I want to get to the point about Zahra salamu alayhi. This surah that we read, Inna A'tainaka al-Kawthar, is one of the surahs about Fada'il Zahra salamu alayhi.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
But before I go to the ayah, I just want your mind just a minute. I want to make a point here about Zahra and her fadila. In Islam, we have one important level, one of the highest level you can get. And it's called Maqam al-Rida. Maqam, the position where you become pleased of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will be pleased by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This maqam is very important. Hatta al-anbiya, even the Prophet, they're looking for that position. In Surah An-Naml, you say, Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam, I said, Rabbi awzi'ni an ashkura ni'mataka allati an'amta alayhi wa an a'mala salihan tarda. Allahu Akbar. Rida Allah, Sulaiman al-Nabi is asking Allah, Ya Allah, make me be among your servants who always appreciate and grateful for your all bounties and your all blessings. And then he said, Ya Allah, help me be among those you always please with their actions. Please. That's how important it is. Yawm al-Qiyamah, Allah said that one of the highest positions a mu'min will achieve is to earn the pleasure of Allah. Wa ridwanullahi akbar. See, in the salat, you say Allahu Akbar. Right? Allah said, Yawm al-Qiyamah, the biggest achievement that every mu'min can achieve is to have the pleasure of Allah. That is one of the highest levels. But there is another level which is higher than this. Which one is that? That level is to have Allah seek your pleasure. Allahu Akbar. That Allah wants to please you. See, the first level, we want to please Allah. That's the highest level. But the second level, which is higher than the first one. No, Allah wants to please you, his servant. And this the level is not the any other people. No, this is the level of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This level, you come to the Quran in Surah Al-Duha, which is one of the Surah of the Prophet, Allah is saying, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Now hear careful. Allah said, يُعْطِيك. He will give you. Right? In the future. Now ask Quran. Ya Quran. مَاذَا أَعْطَى اللَّهُ الرَّسُولُ. He said, يُعْطِيك, right? I will give you. Now where did you give the Quran? Allah said, الْقُرْآنِ يُفَسِّرُ بَعْضُهُ بَعْضًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Rasul said, Inna a'atainakal Allah. We will give you something, Ya Rasulullah, to the point that we will seek your pleasure. Now, Quran, what did Allah give the Prophet? To make the Prophet pleased, Allah said, A'atainakal kawthar. We have given you, Ya Rasulullah, abandon. Allah, look in the Quran. We have al-kawthar and takathur. Takathur? A sharr, something that is not good. Kawthar is good. They both from the same root, al-kathir. But Allah said, Inna a'atainaka al-kawthar. Al-kawthar means abandon, something good that has no end. Ya Rasulullah, ma hu al-kawthar that Allah has given you? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-kawthar Zahra salamu alayhi.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Now you want to understand more about this al-ghayr al-kathir that Allah is talking about? More important, Allahu Akbar. See, if you want to understand Quran, put one ayah next to another ayah to see how Allah describes certain things in the Quran. Al-Quran, when it comes to talk about the entire world, the entire world and what exists in them. The same Quran, Allah said, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعٌ قَلِيلٌ. Allahu Akbar. The entire world, what exists in them, Allah called them qaleel, something little, it's nothing. But the same Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he comes to describe Zahra salamullah alayha, he said to her, أَعْتَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ. We have given you something, ya Rasulullah. That khair is on beyond your imagination. And that is Zahra salamullah alayha. That is one of the maqam of Zahra. Number two, brothers and sisters, you know, in Islam we have four women who are the most highest women in Islam. No woman is like one of these four. They are the highest. One of them is Khadija, the wife of the Prophet. The next one is Asiya bint Muzahim. The third one is Maryam. And for those of us, because some people sometimes they get confused. You say, Maryam is better than Khaldan, Fatima, and so on. No, no, you're not. She's not. Why? They say because Quran says, وَفَضَّلَكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ. No, alameen, yes. فِي زَمَنِهَا. In her time only. She's better than everybody. But that time, not all the time. But Zahra, salamullah alayha, she is the best of awwaleen wal-akhir. She is the third one, and the fourth one is Asiya. Now, I just want to make point about Zahra, salamullah alayha. Now, Asiya, despite the fact she's one of the highest women in Islam, you come to the Quran, when Allah described it, what did Allah say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the wife of Fir'aun, Imra'at Fir'aun, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِمْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنِ. Allah said, set an example for all mu'mineen and mu'minat. With the wife of Fir'aun. إِذْ قَالَتْ. When she made dua, right? She's making dua. إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّي. She called upon Allah. رَبِّي بْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. She's asking Allah, dua. He said, Ya Allah, I want you to build me a house. Where? At your side, at your place, in Jannah. She's asking for herself. Ibn Li, build for me, baytan fil Jannah. That's one. Number two, wa najjini, and protect me, min Fir'aun wa amali. That's two. Number three, وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِ. Three dua, she asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Three. All this dua is all about her. No one is involved. Now Zahra salamullah alayhi. When she makes dua, look at the difference. That this Asiya bint Muzahim, when she makes dua, it's about her. But Zahra salamullah alayha, when she makes dua, her son Imam Hassan, he said, I never heard my mother, when did she make dua? And said, Allah, me, give me, as always give them and give them. Allahu Akbar. Imam Hassan said, one day I came and asked her, his mother, Ya Ummah, why is it that always when you make dua, you don't ask for yourself? I never heard you even one time you call about yourself. You ask Allah. Now the answer of Zahra salamullah alayha, Ya bunayya, oh my son, al-jar thumma dar. Allahu Akbar. That's Zahra. Even yawm al-qiyamah, we have hadith yawm al-qiyamah. When she comes out of the mahshar, she will be coming with the two hands of her son, Abu al-Fadl Abbas. And she stands in Abd al-Mahshar and she said, Ya Allah, I have a request. Ya Zahra, what do you have? Do you want heaven? What do you want? Allahu Akbar. Even Abd al-Mahshar, she said, I want Allah. Uridu mika, Ya Allah. She said, I want from you, Ya Allah, to do a revenge for those who killed my child. Revenge I want from those who killed not my son Imam Hussein alone, and also those who got killed along with Hussein salamullah. Wallah, even Ard al-Mahshar, she's not asking about herself. She's asking about the Shia of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. That is Zahra alayhi salam. Number three, about Fadail Zahra. And this is from Zamakhshari and Suyuti in Tafsir Durr al-Manthur. You know about the Fadail Zahra. That is not about Ahlul Bayt only who mentioned this. Tafsir Durr al-Manthur, the Suyuti, and Zamakhshari in Tafsir al-Kashaf. He quoted this ayah, which is talking about Maryam salamullah alayha. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا. قال أنى لك هذا؟ قالت من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. Now, at the end of this tafsir, Zamakhshari and Suyuti, they mention one hadith about Zahra salamullah alayha. They said one day the Prophet came and the Prophet was hungry. He said, Thalathat ayyam. The Prophet didn't eat. Allahu Akbar. And you know, too much eating is not good anyway. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of his custom is to stay hungry. There is a book of Ayatollah Jawad Amuli. It's called As-Sayru Ilallah, Journey to Allah. And that book, Ayatollah Jawad Amuli Hafadahullah, he mentioned one of the things that can bring you closer to Allah, is lack of eating. Now you want to back this up with the Quran? Yes. Surah Al-Baqarah. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Taqwa, one of the things that can give you taqwa is lack of eating. Rasulullah stays 3 days, no food, nothing. But Rasulullah can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but lack of eating and hunger, it brings you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, hunger, one of the benefits, it helps your brain to function properly. Now you look, as soon as you become full, what happens? The brain shuts. Now you're looking for bed. That's it. But the more you're hungry, the more your brain works. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the time the Prophet is what? Is always hungry. The narration, I'll take you back to Tafsir al-Suyuti and Tafsir al-Zamakhshari. What did they say? They said the Prophet came to his wives. And he said to them, do you have any food in the house? They said, Ya Rasulullah, we don't have anything. The Prophet said, Allah, inni ja'a, I'm hungry. I want something to eat. The Prophet then went to the house of Zahra salamullah. He asked, Ya Zahra, do you have anything in your house? Zahra salamullah alayhi, she said, La, Ya Rasulullah, I don't have anything. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left as he was going. This is from Tafsir Zamakhshari and Suyuti, Dur al-Manthur. They say, a few minutes later, then the Prophet saw a child was running behind the Prophet. Ya Rasulullah, Fatima said, bring this to you. Allahu Akbar. Fatima said, you don't have anything. What happened? How did she get the food? The Prophet came back to ask Zahra. Ya Zahra, min ayna laki hadha? Where did he get this? Fatima alayhi salam says, min indillah, inna allaha yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hasab. Here's the more important. The Prophet said, we opened the food and it was bread and meat. Fajalasna. He said, we sat, the Prophet and Hassan and Hussein and Fatima herself. She said, we sat down and ate the food and finished. Wama naqasa min at-ta'am shay. He said, after we eat, We were full, and we look at the food like nothing happened to the food. Allah, this is the Masharif and Suyuti. In the tafsir, they mention one of the karamat of Zahra, salamullah. That is one of the highest position of Zahra, salamullah. The last one I want to mention, brother, about Fadail al-Zahra in Hadith al-Kisa. Allah, Zahra, if we know her position in the sight of Allah and Ahlul Bayt, Allah, her position is more than what we think. One hadith from Imam Jafar al-Sadiq, he said about Zahra, he said, "Na'nu hujjatullahi alaykum wa Zahra hujjatullahi alayna." La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Imam Jafar, he said, we are the proof of Allah upon all of you, the creatures of Allah. But then Allah makes Zahra to be the proof of Allah on us, Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. And that is why Imam Jafar al-Sadiq said, anytime I hear the name Fatima, he said, أقوم إجلالا لها. Anytime I hear her name, I stand for respect for Zahra, salamu alayhi. Not only Fatima, not only Imam Jafar al-Sadiq, huh? And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever Fatima is coming, he sees her from the far, he stands up waiting for her to come. And when she comes, يُجْلِسُهَا فِي مَجْلِسِهِ. The Prophet leaves and he gives Bahra the position for her to sit. And you know, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he stands up, the entire world stands with the Prophet. When he talks, now look in the Quran. Wallah, it's amazing. When this fada'il, sometimes we think that it's just words. Dawood al-Nabi in the Quran, Allah said about him, that Ya Dawood, when Allah talks about him, and Dawood is one of the Anbiya, it's not even one of the Ulul Azm. But look at the fada'il that Allah gave Dawood. Allah said in the Quran, Ya Dawood, wa'allana lahu al-hadith, wa'at-tayr yusabbihna ma'a. Allah said to the birds and the mountains, this mountain that you see, that when you do tasbih, birds and the mountains, Allah told them, do not go ahead of Dawood. Ya jibalu awwibi, awwib, ay liwafiq, ma'ahu wa tayr wa allana lawn hadid. Allah said to the birds, you're also doing dhikr Allah, right? وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحَ بِحَمْدِهِ. Even birds, they do tasbih. Allah told the birds and the mountains, make sure that when Dawood is doing tasbih, you do the tasbih. But make sure that you're always behind him, not ahead of Dawood. That is the fadila of Dawood alayhi salam. Our Prophet, Allah gave him more than that. When the Prophet stands, the entire kaun and world stands the respect for the Prophet. Now this Prophet, he stands for Zahra, salallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everything stands for what? For Rasulullah, and the Rasulullah stands for Zahra, alayhi wa sallam. And don't think this is just the Prophet is being a father, being kind and nice to his daughter. No, no, no. The Prophet doesn't do anything except with the approval of Allah. Because, see, in Surah, in one of the Surahs, when Nuh, alayhi wa sallam, wanted to even ask Allah's forgiveness for his son. What did Allah say? He said, لا تخاطبني في الذين غيروا. Nabi Allah, one of Ulul Azm, Allah said, don't even talk to me about your son. إنه ليس من أهلك. It's not your son. That is Nabi. So do you think that if the Prophet is just going to do something to respect his daughter just because she is his daughter? Abadan. When he goes to a house, he does Assalamu alayki ya Fatima. Assalamu alaykum ya Ahl al-Bayt. Ata'adhan li an adkhul. Would you give me permission to enter your house? And then the Prophet, Fatima said, Ya Rasulullah, al-Baytu baytuk, wal-Kareematu kareematuk. The house is your house. The daughter is your daughter. Tafadhal. And then the Prophet said, Ya Fatima, inna Allah amarani bidhalik. Allah asked me to do that. Allah asked me to make sure that I do salam and ask your permission first. So when the Prophet stands for Zahra, it's not about being a father who was be kind to his daughter. It's about the amr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. Quran says. When the Prophet leaves the town, the last house he visits is Zahra. When he comes to the house, when he comes back out of town, the first house he visits is the house of Zahra, salam Allah. Now what happened after the death of the Prophet? They attacked that house of Zahra, salam Allah. The narration says, when she was pregnant with their child, which the Prophet suggested to be Muhsin, Samir Muhsin, she was in the house. They attacked the house. Tariq al-Tabari said that when they first approached the house, فَقَالَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْهُمْ, this is the Tariq al-Tabari saying, I said, one of them said to him, the second Khalifa, he said, إِنَّ فِيهَا فَاطِمَةً, in the house there is Fatima. فَكَانَ جَوَابُهُ, his answer was, وَمِنْ, so what if there is Fatima in that house? The narration said, then they attacked the house of Zahra. When they attacked the house, she was behind the door. As soon as they pushed the door so hard, there was a nail. And that door which came right at the back of Zahra, salamullahi alayha. The narration said that nails went direct to her backbone. The narration says she couldn't stand, she has to sit down. She immediately calls Asma, she says, Ya Asma, immediately come with the hijab and help me to stand because I can't stand. Allahu Akbar, Zahra salamullah alayha, 18 years old and she cannot stand. What happened? Because of the tragedy. The narration says a few days later, she lost her son. She had a miscarriage. That son is gone. Not only that, she became sick. And that sickness became worse and worse until the death of Shahada. Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen came and he was around Zahra, salamullahi alayha. The narration said, Zahra said to Imam Ali alayhi salam, I said, I have a wasiyyah to you, I have a will for you, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. What is your will, Ya Zahra? She said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, أُرِيدُكَ أَن تُعَفِّي مَوْضِعَ قَبْرِي, I want you to hide my grave. I don't want those people to participate in my janazah. I don't want them to see where I am buried. This is a question that every Muslim should ask himself. Where is the grave of the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Then he said, Fatima al-Zahra, she said to Imam Ali alayhi salam, وَأَوْسِيكَ أَن تَقْرَأَ لِي هَاتَانِ سُورَتَانِ, I ask you to read these two surahs for me, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. And tonight, anyone who can read these two surahs for Zahra alayhi salam is highly recommended. The first surah is Surah Yasin and Surah Safat. She said, always, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, read these two surahs for me when I pass away. And the narration said, every time after a shahada, Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen used to go to a grave, sit down and read these two surahs. Until one night, Imam Ali was there reading the surahs. The narrator said, فَأَخَذَتُ الْغَفْوَ, Imam Ali alayhi salam felt asleep. Immediately he saw Zahra in his dream, where she said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I have lifted this responsibility. You don't have to come anymore to read these surahs for me. You can read it at home. Imam Ali asked, وَلِمَا يَا زَهْرَىٰ, why? Then Zahra said, she said, I saw Imam Hassan and Hussein. They woke up and I'm not there. No, you are there. فَأَرَيْتُمَا مُنْكَسِرَانِ الْقَلْبَ, I saw them have broke hearted. And I don't want this to happen anymore, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. Ud ila dar, or go back to the house, take care of Hassan al-Hussein alayhi wasalam. Imam Ali alayhi salam rushed to the house and he saw Imam Hassan al-Hussein. They were going back and forth. Aina Ummuna Zahra, Aina Amir al-Mu'mineen. And none of them were there. Allahu Akbar. Imam Ali alayhi salam, he then rushed and hugged them and he said, Ha ana abukuma ya Hassan al-Hussein. I am here, my father. And then he hugged them and they all cried for Zahra alayhi salam. And this is how the enemies of Allah took care of the door of the Prophet after his death. وَسَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَيَّ مُنْقَلَبٍ يَنْقَلِبُونَ والعاقبة للمتقين. اللهم إلهنا نسألك وندعوك يا الله. يا الله بحق الزهراء عليك يا الله. يا الله بحق مريد كربلاء زين العابدين شافي جميع مرضى المسلمين يا الله. Ya Allah, for the sake of Imam Zayd al-Abidin, the sake of Karbala, Ya Allah, give fast recovery for all mu'minin and mu'minat, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, we ask you, our brothers and sisters who are going through difficulty, Ya Allah, for the sake of Zahra, Ya Allah, solve all the problems for all mu'minin and mu'minat, Ya Rabbal Alameen. إلى أمواتكم وأموات المؤمنين رحم الله من قرأ الفاتحة مع الصلوات. Brothers, don't leave. There's ziyarah of Zahra, inshallah.